I think very early on we realized that we couldn't make any dent in the fight against poverty without not doing one project, two project, three project, but really thousands of projects. This is where the creation of organizations like JPAL, which is the organization that Brigitte and I started, and IPA, which is the organization that Dean started, were critical. One of the things that happened that is tremendously positive in the last several years is what happened to the world's poorest. Even in countries that remain quite poor, there has been a great improvement in the quality of life of the poorest. For example, infant mortality was halved. Maternal mortality also went down. Most of kids are in school, etc. So all of these things are really very tangible, ultra important gains that the poor have experience in their lives. And I think we, these movements, and that would mean IPA as well, have played some role in that. So for example, if you take malaria, the main reason for the big decline in malaria cases and malaria deaths over the last 10 years or so is the vast spread of bed nets. In the early 2000s, there was a dispute on whether bed nets should be given for free or they should be sold. And, you know, there is no way to know without doing the research. It shouldn't be about ideology. It shouldn't be about intuition. Anybody could be right. But the research was done. And that was done, you know, in Kenya by IPA Kenya. And the results, first people started to question it, but when experiences were replicated in different countries, it became clear that the first order effect of prices is to discourage people from buying the nets, and everything else is inexistent. And that was actually sufficient, combined with the outreach effort that followed, which again takes a movement and many people and many staff who kind of slowly, patiently discuss those results with the actors in the ecosystem. That was sufficient to really lead to a switch in the rhetoric around the distribution of bed nets and the adoption in many African countries of free bed net distribution. And that really is single-handedly responsible for the decline in malaria cases and malaria deaths. So when you have an example like that where you can see the entire chain going from one piece of research to the replication of the research to the diffusion to policymakers, you can see the importance of having an organization like IPA, which has presence on the ground and is there permanently and can relay the results until such point as they become, you know, part of the policymaking world. And this infrastructure that's embodied into, for example, IPA, hundreds of staff all around the world, is what has helped this movement become a movement and not just the research peeves of a couple of people.